My interest is really in antibiotic resistance, and a lot of my work in recent years has been developing clinical trials to try and answer some critical questions to help us define the best way to treat patients with these very difficult infections. So we're here in my home here, and it's surprisingly very quiet. My children are usually running around screaming, fighting with each other, but they're very lively and very entertaining. Look, when I was younger, I actually had ambitions to be a musician and an artist, until I realized I really had very little talent in either. I still tinker a little bit. I play a little bit of guitar, piano, just to keep myself sane. So my name's Patrick Harris. I'm an infectious disease physician and medical microbiologist. I did a diploma in tropical medicine at the London School of Hygiene. And so I got an opportunity to go and work in a large city in Malawi. In more recent decades, antibiotics have become freely available, and there's been a lot of misuse of antibiotics, and similarly, they have a heavy burden of infectious diseases. And the combination of these two things is really a recipe for disaster in many of these developing countries. The research we do here at the University of Queensland can really help inform our understanding of how to break the cycle of this emerging infection, and also guide treatment for patients that have severe disease. I got to know David Patterson here in Brisbane, who's one of the sort of Australian leading lights in antibiotic resistance research. And we were talking about developing this clinical trial called the Merino trial. So this trial took nearly 5 years to complete. So we were picking these patients who have these bloodstream infections and also had quite profound antibiotic resistant strains. And we were trying to decide between two different antibiotics. We've never been too certain for these types of infections, which of these two antibiotics would be the best. If you estimate the number of lives saved by choosing the correct antibiotic as defined by this trial, this would equate to many tens of thousands of lives saved across the world potentially.